Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. It's me, Saba Sayed, and I'm here with a new topic of graphical analysis of motion. It is the third lecture of chapter number 2 of class 9 physics, which is used by Punjab textbook board. It is also used by FBISE. Here's the graphical analysis of motion. First of all, graph is a pictorial way of presenting information about the relation between various quantities. The quantities between which the graph is plotted are called the variables. One of the quantity is called the independent quantity, and the other quantity, the value of the which varies with the independent quantity, is called dependent quantity. One of which is called independent quantity and other is called dependent quantity. Independent quantity don't depend on any quantity, while dependent quantity depend on the independent quantity. Distance time graph. It is useful to represent the motion of objects using graphs. The term distance and displacement are used interchangeably when the motion is in a straight line. Similarly, if the motion is in a straight line, then speed and velocity are also used interchangeably. In a distance time graph, time is taken along horizontal axis, while vertical axis show the distance covered by the object. Or in other words, we can say that time is taken along x-axis, while distance covered by the object is taken along y-axis. When object is at rest. In this graph, the distance moved by the object with time is zero. This is the object is at rest. Thus, a horizontal line parallel to time axis on a distance time graph show that the speed of the object is zero. Here in this graph, you can see along x-axis time is taken, along y-axis distance in meter is taken, and a straight line along x-axis show that object is at rest. It means that no distance is covered by the object and object is still at point at a 15 meter, and time is covering, so distance is not covered by object, so the object is at rest. Next, object is moving with constant speed. The speed of an object is said to be constant if it covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. The distance time graph is a straight line. Its slope gives the speed of the object. Here you can consider two points A and B on the graph. So speed of light is equal to the slope of line AB. If we can say distance EF is equal to is distance covered by the object, and time CD is the time taken by the object. So distance at point F, it is distance 30 meter, and at point E it is 10 meter. So it will be 30 minus 10, and for time at point D it is 15 meter, and at point C it is 5 meter. So it will be 15 minus 5. So after calculating, the speed of object will be 20 over 10, which is equal to 2 meter per second. So the speed found from the graph is 2 meter per second. Object moving with variable speed. When an object does not cover equal distance in equal intervals of time, then its speed is not constant. In this case, the distance time graph is not a straight line. Here in this graph, you can see a pink line, which is the variable speed of moving object. The slope of the curve at any point can be found from the slope of the tangent or that point. For example, here you can see the object is not the speed of object is not constant. So we draw a tangent on its speed. Then we will divide it into its component along y component and x component. The y component is equal to rs and x component is equal to qs. Here in this picture you can see along the time t you can see the point q and s, and along the distance d you can see at 30 there is a point r on the slope r, and there is on 0, there is a point S. So the slope of the tangent at point P is equal to y over x. For y it is rs and for x it is qs. Rs is equal to 30 meter, which is the distance, and qs is equal to 10 second, which is the time. For s it is on 15, for q it is on 5. Minus 5 from 15 we get 10 seconds. Here after calculating it we get 3 meter per second, which is the speed of the object which is moving with variable speed. The speed of the object at point P is 3 meter per second. The speed is higher at instant when slope is greater. Speed is 0 at instant where slope is horizontal. Here this is speed time graph. In speed time graph, time is taken along x-axis and speed is taken along y-axis. As we know, in distance time graph, distance is taken along y-axis and similarly time is taken along x-axis. When object is moving with constant speed, when object was at rest, then same graph was shown by the distance time graph at rest. So for object moving with constant speed, we have when the speed of an object is constant with time, then the speed time graph will be a horizontal line parallel to time axis along x-axis. In other words, a straight line parallel to time axis represents constant speed of the object. Here in this graph you can see pink line shows the constant speed of the object. Along y-axis we have velocity or speed in meter per second, and along x-axis we have time in seconds. Object moving with uniformly changing speed or uniform acceleration. Let the speed of an object be changing uniformly. In such a case, speed is changing at constant rate. Thus, its speed time graph would be a straight line. A straight line means that the object is moving with uniform acceleration. Slope of the line gives the magnitude of its acceleration. Here in this graph, you can see on horizontal axis we have time in seconds. On vertical axis we have velocity in meter per second. So the or we can say it is speed in meter per second, and the slope which is in pink color, and it shows the acceleration of the object, or we can say uniform acceleration of the object. That's all for today's lecture. Thanks a lot. Thanks for watching.